제120회 날씨가 얼마나 좋은데.
안녕하세요. Hello everyone and welcome to Let's Speak Korean. I'm your host Lisa Kelly and today is our 120th program. And today's main expression is something I really want to say every day. 날씨가 얼마나 좋은데. Oh, the weather is wonderful. What are you talking about? And you're looking pretty wonderful there. All that working out is
Gee, thanks. A compliment. Hey, yeah. 안녕하세요. I'm Stephen Revere. Wow. Thank you everybody for joining us. It's wonderful to have you with us again so we can teach a few more Korean expressions. We're going to talk a little bit about the weather, as you may have heard, the very diverse weather in Korea, lots of different kinds. But you can talk about how wonderful the weather is today after you learn today's expressions.
날씨가 참 좋아요.
Good.
안녕하세요. 저 네오미입니다.
날씨가 얼마나 좋은데. 안녕하십니까. 콜린입니다.
Learn today's expression.
I know already. We don't even have to do anything. Well, as Stephen mentioned, the weather is very diverse here, ranging from very cold to very hot, sweltering hot in the summer. Lots of rain, some snow, windy weather too. It's great here. And actually, I would have to say, in the beginning, I used to really hate the very extreme weathers, but now it's like I'm enjoying everything. When it rains, I'm like, wow, 날씨가 얼마나 좋은데. And people are like, what? What are you talking about? But hey, it's all good.
And I still love the sound of the mamie. I know everybody makes fun of me now. Oh, why do you like that? They're cicadas in English. They're called cicadas. But nobody really knows that word that I've met. I suppose a few people do. But the mamie in Korean, oh, I love that sound.
When the sun comes scorching out, it gets hot, and then they just all start ringing at the same time. It gets pretty annoying, Stephen. I don't know. All right, let's get started. Here is Let's Do It.
Let's do it.
낮잠이나 자야겠다.
날씨가 얼마나 좋은데 낮잠을 자.
Today's first expression was 낮잠이나 자야 되겠다 or 자야겠다. Okay, 낮잠. Okay, we know what the word 잠 is sleep. But then when we're adding words in front of here, we're changing what kind of sleep. For example, 낮잠 would be sleeping during the day. In other words, a nap. And then what else do we have? 그냥 regular sleep, 잠자다. Let's try all of these. Okay, 잠자다, 낮잠 자다, 늦잠 자다.
잠자다, 늦잠 자다, 낮잠 자다.
낮잠이다, 자야겠다.
Okay, he went ahead and said the sentence, 낮잠이나 자야 되겠다. And that's good because that's what Stephen's going to help us out. When we put the 나 in the sentence, that actually expresses something else, right?
Yeah, when you throw in that 나, you've got 잠 자야 되겠다, right? 자야겠다. But here you also throw in the 이나, which actually what that expresses, I love this. What we do with intonation, Koreans usually do with an extra add-on at the end. They tag on a little verb or syllable at the end there. Here, you're tagging on na or ina if it's got a pachim. So, cham, because it has a pachim, the miam at the bottom, that little box, it goes up there. You must say cham ina. And what that's doing is saying, well, I would like to do something, you know, wonderful or spectacular, but I can't. I'm not gonna. So I'm just gonna do this, all right?
Okay. Like a lot of expressions in Korea, it shows 아쉬움, which is regret, or here, I like to translate it as, since I can't do something, I'll settle for this.
Settle for, that's good. Yeah, it just shows that it's not your first choice, but it's okay. You'll
or
go with
might
that.
As well. Might as well do this rather than A, okay? So, you know, 낮잠이나 자야 되겠다. When I don't have anything to do, why not a nap? Or Stephen's wonderful example that he likes to use is Koreans eat rice all the time, so 라면이나 먹어야 되겠다. Might as well eat some ramen. Okay, let's think of some examples. I'll give you a sentence, and why don't you try to say it. Might as well play computer games, Naomi?
컴퓨터 게임이나 해야겠다.
Very good. And once again, we have the example where the English is taken, derived from the English into the Korean language. It's computer games, but we say 컴퓨터 게임. Okay. All right. Colin, here's one for you. Okay. Might as well call somebody.
아, 전화, 통화나 해야겠다.
Okay. You know, notice that 해야 하다 is to have to do something, right? 해야 하다, I have to do it. 해야겠다. It seems like you're just, what, adding on future tense there or something like that?
Yeah. Okay.
저는, 저는 끊어야 되겠다. What are you doing? Yes. When you're throwing on the future tense there, all you're doing is saying, well, oh, I gotta do this, right? You're throwing it into the future tense. It's just a combination of two grammar forms. You're showing that this sounds like it would be a good idea.
Right, I should do something. 나가야겠다, 밥 먹어야겠다, 겠다. Practice those, okay? And then we have our response to this sentence. We heard, 날씨가 얼마나 좋은데. Okay, let's cut it here. Okay, up to here, because the intonation changes when we add the rest of the sentence. So we'll just go up to here. 날씨가 얼마나 좋은데. 날씨 is weather. 얼마나, how much or a lot of something. And then 좋은데, 좋다. It's very good. Oh, the weather is so good. And this is like, you're not stating it. You're actually, what's the word I'm looking for here? When you want to suggest, oh, it's so good. What are you talking about? Okay. 날씨가 얼마나 좋은데. Try that.
날씨가 얼마나 좋은데.
Right. 날씨가 좋은다.
얼마나?
얼마나 좋은데.
Okay, here you want to emphasize 얼마나, because we're saying, oh, it's so good. What are you talking about?
And that's exactly what this expression does, right? Is emphasize stuff. You're stressing the fact that it is beautiful weather. You could say, 얼마나 맛있는데.
Right?
Oh, it's so delicious. Oh, it's just wonderful. Or 얼마나 예쁜데.
Woo!
Oh, she's so beautiful,
thanks,
right?
Okay.
Look at this, both her butt, both sides of me. Oh, you're talking about me, huh?
Oh, Stephen and 얼마나 착한데.
It's an example.
Okay, no, I'll give an example. Stephen and 얼마나 착한데.
Yeah, oh, what a nice guy. Oh, that's very good. Yeah.
All right, have you seen our flash animation? 얼마나 재밌는데요? Let's go take a look at our flash animation.
Wrap it up
with Lisa
and Stephen.
나는 이제 그만 집에 가야겠어.
날씨가 이렇게 좋은데 집에 가?
햇볕이 너무 강해서 얼굴이 너무 탈 것 같아.
선크림 발라.
사ying that there are so many different ways to describe adjectives and words in the Korean language, and you're never going to find them all in a book for you. You've got to be here and live it here to really experience and know. And we have some examples here today. We'll just cover the ones we heard. The first one was the sun's rays or the sun's light, okay? We're saying, Stephen was saying, oh, that's too extreme, or I think Lisa said it. Yeah, I did. Okay, and the word we heard was 햇볕이. 햇볕이. 햇 is 해. 해 is sun. And then what we're saying is we're describing the sun's rays here. And another one we heard was 타다, okay? And this is a verb that has so many different meanings. We could probably sit here all day, but we'll just go over a couple of the common words. When we say, oh, you're burning your food, how do we say that, Steve?
You're burning your food, that's a little tough. I'll go with the food is burning, right? Oh, 음식이 타고 있어요, right? 음식이 타고 있어요. The food is burning. Yeah, 타다 can be to burn. Also be ride in a car, right?
In case of like
택시를 타다.
택시를 타다, 차를 타다. And what about when you're at the beach? Hey, I'm riding the waves, or the waves are like moving, okay?
Still riding.
파도를 타다.
And then your face.
Okay, and we heard that.
Can get burnt too, right? 얼굴이.
얼굴이 타다 or 탄다.
Right. Your face can burn as well.
Another really interesting cultural point is that in Western countries and in Europe as well, it's a good thing to get a tan on your face. But here,
no.
You got to be as white as possible.
Everybody's white.
I go back
to California. My friends go, "What's wrong? They don't have sun in Korea." No tans here.
Very funny. I know. It's very interesting. Anyways, join us back here next time, and we'll see you then. Bye bye.
That's right. Thanks for being with us. Arirang TV.com, everybody.